Welcome guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. And if you're seeing my face for the first time, my name is Betty. Please do well to stick around by hitting the subscribe button down below and do well to tap on the notification bell beside it so as to be notified whenever I post new content on here. And do not forget to give this video a thumbs up by liking it and do well to leave me a comment as well. Guys, let's relate. I love you guys. Thank you for all the support and I'm back for good, yeah? So guys, in today's video, I want to talk about the struggles of a Nigerian YouTuber or a small YouTuber like myself. Because sometimes it can be so crazy, you can be so discouraged and you just run away. Like I have been away for months. I literally ran away. So what's a good time to talk about the struggle right now? And using myself as an example. So let's get right into the video. Okay guys, I'm so excited. I totally relate to this thing that I'm about to talk about. Stick around and do not forget to subscribe, like I said, to this channel. Yeah, so let's get right into the video. So the number one struggle I have here on my book, if you see me looking down, I have highlighted at least four struggles here that I totally relate to. So the number one struggle I have right now is light. Light is a huge problem and a barrier to being a content creator generally, because sometimes you could be filming. I've seen it happen to a couple of YouTubers and a couple of content creators, and you're filming and then the light just goes off. It's never guaranteed. Okay, and then if you have to use, of course you have to use lighting and the whole setup, and then the light goes off. What do? You start running fuel for those of them that have generator, because I'm just a young girl that's trying to survive. I do not have money to establish all of those things right now, so you have to start running fuel. And in this country right now, a liter of fuel is so far about 500 to 600 naira, and how much fuel is just enough for you to do all your work? And it's harder for the small YouTubers like myself when we haven't started earning on here, or we are still struggling. We are still struggling to get our food on this community, right? Yeah, so we're still struggling. Sometimes it can be so discouraging that you just can't deal, yeah. You just can't deal. So light is definitely a major barrier to filming content, because what is creating content without good lighting, yeah? Nothing. So that is a huge problem that I face personally as well. So most times you have to just film where there's like natural light and you have good filming space and all of that. So yeah, so number one thing I have here on my list is network and data. I'm sure a whole lot of you can relate as well. Data and network, we are faced with network and data wahala in this country. Like being a Nigerian, it's hard. And if you see a Nigerian out there today, do well to put something in our pocket. Do well to encourage those that are trying to make a living, because it's really tough, yeah? So sometimes you're done, you eventually film your videos and you have data, but for you to upload, especially when you have a time frame of uploading videos, if you tell your subscribers 6 p.m. and then at 6:20, 6:30, your videos are still uploading because of a bad network. And sometimes you spend so much for data but get very little. Even when you try to do packages that have been offered by these telecommunication services, it just isn't enough. So you end up paying so much for little. And this can be so discouraging, because you have to keep the content rolling. You have to keep working. You have to keep thriving to survive, people. So what is life without data and network? So network and data is a huge barrier to Nigerian YouTubers and to content creators in general. And so this is not downstream to just YouTubers, but content creating or content creators in general. Yeah, the third problem would be lack of support. So lack of support is a problem, and it can be so discouraging if you're trying to become a content creator, because you feel like you're doing the little you can and not getting the attention. And for YouTube, if you do not understand the YouTube how YouTube works generally, that you have to be consistent, you have to put in the work, you have to come here, you have to show up to work for you to see results. I don't think you are even going to last. And I am an example of that, because I felt like, oh, my mates were going faster than I was, maybe something was doing wrong. Yeah. And then I wasn't seeing results. So it's really a problem, lack of support. And then you're posting your links and people really do not understand that. Okay, even people do not even know that. When they say subscribe to my YouTube channel, that is free. So if you are one of those persons that do not know that subscribing to a YouTube channel is absolutely free, please do the time to hit the subscribe button down below. Please, guys, it's your way of showing support and just putting effort and coming to work and showing up to work, because this is work, this is my job right now. It will be so motivating and encouraging to just come up each day and see that, oh, I've gotten new subscribers and people are actually watching, as they're literally encouraging me, friends and family. If you are seeing this right now, please support this girl by hitting the subscription button down below. And subscription is absolutely free, so you do not have to pay. Nobody's taking money from your account too. Thank you and God bless you. So the fourth and the last on my list will be filming location. This is one of my major problems. I totally relate. As you can see right now, I'm just sitting in my little space and I'm filming this and I'm talking to you guys. I'm yet to set up a filming space, and you know, everything is packaging, Sha. You shall know that one. So if you don't package yourself well and build your own aesthetics, how do people enjoy, or how people enjoy watching you? So you need to have a filming space, whatever you're shooting, fashion, lifestyle videos, DIYs, you need to have a good environment, and that has always been a problem. Sometimes you go out to restaurants and you need to tip people to shoot at such locations. Sometimes you need to, yeah, you generally need to tip some people to allow you access some facilities to do your shooting, your videos, and your content creating in general. So filming location and space is a problem, and it's hard to even get these locations, because I don't know if it's like that with foreign or outsiders, but I'm talking about specifically talking about Nigerian and being a Nigerian YouTuber. I mean, finding a location to film is such a fuss. Like, it can be so hectic, because you end up spending money and tipping people here and there to get a space, and everything is expensive. So yeah, guys, those are the four challenges I feel YouTubers face that discouraging some of them, and some of them is me. So if you relate to these, or you have more problems you'd like to share with me, please do well to leave them in the description box, and let's talk. Let's just continue the conversation in the comment section. I said description box, pardon me, please. Watch to this point and you haven't liked this video, or you haven't subscribed, I don't know what you're doing. What do you want me to do? Please tell me, what do you want me to do? So if you've watched to this point, please do well to hit the subscribe button, give this video a thumbs up, and do not forget to leave a comment in the comment section. I look forward to seeing you in my next video. Thank you, guys, and I love you.